Thank you. something on your mind, Elise? Has some rugged, handsome young man caught your eye? Like your brother, perhaps?
Please, Your Highness. I just thought I saw someone I recognized. But it couldn't possibly have been him. I can't imagine what would bring him to the capital this early in the morning.
Someone you recognized? I wonder. But I knew you wouldn't deny it. That your brother is handsome, I mean.
Please. I knew that I shouldn't have told you about him.
Oh, come now. I'm only teasing. There's no need to sulk. I'll give you a little something from Mariage Cross to make up for it.
But that's an adult lingerie brand. Please excuse us, Captain Claire.
I'm sorry. I hope I haven't sullied your ears with our scandalous conversation.
Not at all, Your Highness. I came to inform you that the special train to the Imperial Villa will be arriving shortly. I look forward to accompanying you today.
It'll be a pleasure to have you with us.
Certainly.
Thank you.
Let's get started. Go on, draw a card. After you, then. What? You can't do that. Bolt! You've done it. What? You can't do that. Oh, now you've done it. Mirror. I won. Please go easy on me. Shall we draw then? Oh, we have the same score. Let's draw again. Allow me to play first then. I'm gonna use a bolt card. Ouch, I wasn't expecting that. Oh no, this could be trouble. Sorry, I'm using a mirror. Oh, we have the same score. Let's draw again. Oh, it looks as though the first move is yours. Oh no, you beat me.
If we have to. Draw a card. We have the same score. Let's redraw. We have the same score. Let's redraw. We have the same score. Let's redraw. I'll be going first. Impertinent little. Now you've done it. Oh, you impertinent little. Oh, you impertinent little. At least it wasn't a complete waste of time.
Shall we begin? Go ahead and draw. You should go first then. It seems we need to draw again. You should go first then. I hate to do this, but. Well done. It seems we need to draw again. It seems we need to draw again. It seems we need to draw again. I'll go first then. It seems the winds are on my side.
there won't be any need for that. What?
No way.
Sharon? How did you get here before us? The power of my love for you allows me to do the impossible, my lady. And as you'll see, I've prepared packed lunches for all of you that far surpass this morning's offerings. I do hope you'll enjoy them.
Thanks.
We really appreciate you going to all the trouble to make these for us.
True. That said, I'm really curious how you got here before us.
It seems that the Reinford family's maid enjoys a little amusement at the expense of her employer. I imagine you transferred to an airship in the capital?
Ah.
Of course. Why didn't I think of that? You can cut the time from Heimdall to Ruhr in half if you travel by airship, I think.
You got me. I took advantage of the opportunity to borrow the airship's kitchen so I could make your lunches as well. They're quite fresh, so take a moment to savor the taste.
Well, thank you.
We really do appreciate all you're doing for us.
Honestly, I knew you had to be up to something. You're not planning on coming all the way to the Nord Highlands with us now, are you?
I'd love to, but unfortunately, I have some other business I must attend to. I may not be able to return to Trista for a while, either.
Other business?
Sharon will be assisting me with my work.
Mother?
Hello, Elisa. Ah, you all must be members of Class 7. I'm Elisa's mother, Irina, also the chairman of the Reinford Group. It's a pleasure to meet you.
The pleasure is ours. I'm Reen Schwarzer.
Pleased to meet you. My name is Emma Milstein.
Gaius Warzel. Glad to make your acquaintance.
Eustace Albarea. A pleasure.
I'm glad you're all managing to get along with my obstinate daughter. I wish I could stay a while, but unfortunately I've work that can't wait. Come along, Sharon.
As you wish, Madam Chairman. What?
Seriously? You show up like this and that's all you have to say? It's always work with you, isn't it? You probably didn't even notice I left home until I was already gone. Now it's just, hello, Elisa, and that's it?
My lady.
I did get the impression her relationship with her mother wasn't all sunshine and gumdrops.
Seems there's a lot of friction between them.
You can live your life however you see fit. I have no intention of forcing the Reinford Group on you. Even if you decide to follow a certain someone's path and cast aside all sense of responsibility, it's your choice to make. Besides, I still manage to keep myself informed of the general goings-on in your academic life, in the monthly reports I receive from the Academy.
What? I knew Sharon would relay back information about me, but reports from the Academy itself?
Oh, you must not have known. In addition to my other responsibility, I also sit on the Academy's board of directors.
Oh, my. That means...
Just like Rufus.
It does appear that way. I'd certainly deem the chairman of the Reinford Group a canny choice as a member of the board.
The Reinford Group is heavily involved in the development of the Orbal staff, as well as your Arcus. I must say, I'm quite pleased with the reports I've received on your usage of both. I'm looking forward to seeing the results of this month's field study as well. Do give me some good reading, won't you?
Please excuse us, my lady. Take care during the rest of your journey.
Elisa?
You all right? Apart from the bustle of the city.
It really is. I feel like I'm one with the wind.
Indeed, but if you didn't go too fast, that would be great.
I'm sure it will feel natural in time. No doubt the riding club would be fuming with envy if they could see us now.
I'll bet.
Anyway, my home settlement is due northeast of here. Hopefully, we'll be able to reach it before sundown.
Right.
Let's move!
Yeah!
excited as a child.
I think I'm just caught up in the moment.
Sun's almost down.
We're almost at the settlement. Let's keep up the pace, guys.
Thank you.